North Carolina's state health plan is denying some coverage of GLP-1 weight loss drugs, including Wegovy, Ozempic, and Mounjaro, as of April 1st. The state's saying the drugs are too expensive. Our next guest, though, says it's more cost-effective in the long term to continue that coverage. For more, we have University of Pennsylvania Vice Provost for Global Initiatives, Dr. Ezekiel Emanuel. He covered this in a recent op-ed. Dr. Emanuel, first of all, thank you so much for being here. So the state is saying that they are not going to, they are going to grandfather in the folks who were approved to have coverage of these drugs last year, but from April 1st, they are no longer going to cover them. Why do you think that this is not the most cost-effective move in this case?
So the justification for changing their policy, according to the executive director of the health plan, was it has to be cost, we're guided by cost effectiveness, he said, and we have to do the greatest good for the greatest number. But in fact, if you look at the cost effectiveness analyses of these drugs for patients who have obesity, they're cost effective. They in fact meet his criteria, and they do a lot of good for patients who have obesity. Not only do they reduce weight, they also reduce their risk of cardiovascular disease by 20% in the first year. So they meet his standard of cost effectiveness. He did not actually do the calculations and examine whether they're cost effective or not. We also point out that the North Carolina Health Plan covers many drugs that are much less cost effective than the GLP-1 drugs like Ozempic and Wegovy for obese patients. They cover some cancer drugs, they cover some drugs for other diseases that are not as cost effective.
Wouldn't Dr. Emanuel, though, providing this coverage cost a lot of money? Where would that money be coming from? How would North Carolina pay for that?
So that's a separate issue. It's not a cost effectiveness issue, it's a budget issue. Things can be cost effective and still hit the budget hard, and I'm sympathetic to him. These are expensive. So there seem to me to be three options. One, you could try to reduce the cost of drugs and negotiate them down. You know, we've had Congress, which has been sort of reluctant to negotiate a lot of drugs. We have for 2026 the first bill ever to negotiate drug prices. I think, and I was a big advocate of that, I think that's a good thing. We could try to negotiate down these particular drugs because they're going to be widely used. The second approach is, look, don't just cut off a whole swath of people with one diagnosis, like obesity. Use the drugs for the people who get the most benefit or who need them the most. And the third approach that we argue is, look, you want to pay for these drugs? Tax the very problem that is causing obesity, ultra high processed foods and soda, sugar sweetened beverages. Tax them, use the money you get from the tax to pay for these obesity drugs. That accomplishes two things. You treat the people who have obesity today, and you prevent people from getting obesity by increasing the tax on these foods. That's another solution that they never even considered in North Carolina. And I think that is, you know, you an ounce of prevention and the pound of cure.
What do you say, Dr. Emanuel? I'm interested in your take, because when people propose, you know, like you're doing, raising taxes on soda, candy, you'll often hear this criticism. You're unfairly kind of, listen, hurting more low-income folks, right? I mean, you raise the price of a can of Coke by 10 cents, 50 cents. It doesn't matter. I'm still going to buy a can of Coke. But maybe lower-income folks couldn't. It's regressive, people argue. How do you sort of respond to that?
Well, obesity and the other diseases caused by those drinks and poor diets, type 2 diabetes and other diseases, osteoarthritis, the need for joint replacements early, the foreshortened lifespan, those are not good things either. And inducing people to change their diet to be more healthy is a good thing. And that's a very important effect. Bad health disproportionately affects poor people, I agree. And encouraging them to switch what they're eating to healthier items by taxing the unhealthy items, that's also a good thing for them because it reduces their ill health and I think would be better for them, both in the short term and in the long term.
I'm curious if you think healthcare plans are going to listen to you. And in other words, you know, it's not just North Carolina, of course. There are a lot of both public and private health plans right now that are weighing whether to cover these drugs. And so do you think that this is going to continue to be problematic? And even though the health benefits of these drugs have been widely touted, we've talked about them a lot here from a profitability standpoint for these companies as well. Do you think that that promise is not going to be fulfilled if the drugs aren't covered?
Well, let's raise two or three points here. First of all, the profitability is directly tied to the super high prices. And so I think I think part of the ethical thing to do is to bring those prices down. And I don't think we should keep the super high prices. And I'm hoping that with more development of these drugs, like Inc. Pharmaceuticals just yesterday announced that they had very good data results. Hopefully that'll keep up. We'll have a lot more drugs and maybe that competition will drive the price down. The second thing I would say is that these are, I mean, we do have a big health problem and we do have to recognize that there are things we can do in our society around the health problems. We created this problem overnight. We didn't create this problem overnight. You know, it's taken us about six decades to get to this big obesity epidemic. I don't think this is the only way we should attack it, but I do think we have to, if we have effective treatments, we need to use them. When we have effective treatments for lung cancer or diabetes or cirrhosis, we use them. And I think we have to use an effective treatment for obesity.
When you, Dr. Emanuel, when you refer to obesity here, as I think you said, epidemic, can you quantify that for us? How much of a crisis is it for the country?
It's a huge crisis. 70% roughly of the adult population is either overweight or obese, where obese is a BMI above 30. It's a huge problem for most adults.